Alright, so here we are again in the Kotlin REPL, and in this lecture we're going to talk about the basic data types Kotlin has to offer. Data types are basically the types of your variables. So what we've seen so far are strings, which is a data type, and strings basically represent text. We've seen this before. You can define a string by opening up double quotes and just typing whatever you like Kotlin. Press Control Enter, and it's going to give you the value, which is just the text you put into the double quotes. What we've also seen are integers, and we've also had some floating point numbers. Now, in this lecture, we're going to go into more detail and look at each of the basic data types. First of all, let's recap the string again. So if I want to create a value or a variable of type string, I can just type val, for example, to create a value. And call it whatever I like, equals I love ice cream. Now with strings, what we can do is we can concatenate them pretty easily. We can just use the plus, because plus is defined as a concatenation for strings. So we can say hello Kotlin by concatenating these two strings containing hello and then a space and Kotlin. So this evaluates to the concatenation of the two strings. So whenever you want to store a text, you can use a string variable or a value. Now the next data type I want to talk about is a Boolean. And a Boolean is pretty much the simplest data type because it can have only two values which represent true or false. So if I type in something like 3 less than 4, what this is going to evaluate to is true. Similarly, if I type 4 less than 3, this is going to give me false. And these are the two values a Boolean variable can take on. So again, I can store a result like this in a variable or a value, and let's call it my Boolean. And this is 7 less than 4. So my Boolean should be false. Alright, so we're going to talk more about Booleans when we talk about conditionals, because the condition will be a true or a false statement. Now next, there are various ways to represent numbers, and these basically only differ in the amount of numbers they can take on. So the more memory the data type takes, the more numbers it can store. Now the smallest of these data types for storing numbers is a byte. And a byte takes, well, 1 byte of memory, and it can store numbers between minus 128 and 127. So let's create a variable of the type byte. Now the problem is, if I type val b equals 4, by default Kotlin is going to use an integer to store this value. So I have to explicitly tell Kotlin to make this a byte. And I can do that by specifying the val keyword first, as always, then the name of the variable I want to define, and then I put a colon and the name of the data type I want to use, like byte. And let's give it the 127. Now you don't see any difference compared to just using an int in this case, but it takes less memory on your computer. And I can print this as always by just typing the name of the variable and pressing Control Enter. The next in line is called a short. And a short can take numbers between minus 32,768 and 32,767. So that's already quite a bit more. And let's just create one like this. So the important thing to note is that we can specify the type of a variable or value explicitly by putting a colon behind the name of our variable and then specifying the name of the data type we want to use. So let's go on. The next one is our integer. And we can do this the same way we did before, by typing in int as the name of the data type. But as I mentioned, we could do the same thing by just saying equals 7, because by default Kotlin is going to use an integer to store this. Now an integer can take on pretty large numbers, so we're talking about a range from minus 2 billion and something to 2 billion and something. So this is sufficient in most use cases, and that's why the integer is the default data type for storing integers like this. But if we do need really large numbers, we can still use a data type that can store even more numbers, and that one is called long, for a good reason. And well, how do we do that? We can create a variable again by specifying the name and the data type, and we can put in a pretty large number here. Don't want to go too far, but this should be all right. And if we scroll down, we're going to see what it did, and we can print the value. All right, those are all the types that we can use for integers. I want to shortly mention another way you can specify a long variable, and that is if you type something like 3 and a uppercase L, that's also going to tell Kotlin to make it a long variable. Now I have to scroll down. Now that's pretty overkill just to store a 3, but you get the point. Next, we also have to store floating point numbers, which we've also already done before. But there are actually two different data types for storing floating point numbers. And the first one that takes less memory and is less precise is called a float. So let's just call this one F, and this is a float, which we're going to give 3.73. And if we scroll down, this is actually going to give us an error. And that's because I forgot to tell Kotlin explicitly that this is a float, because by default, Kotlin uses double values to store floating point numbers like these. So for Kotlin, this is a double and does not implicitly transform this double value into a float. So to do that, we're going to have to tell Kotlin to explicitly make this a float, and we can do this similar to the long variable. So we can put a lowercase f at the end, and this is going to tell Kotlin to make this a float variable. So now there is no error anymore, and we can print out our value. Now, since double is the default value, just like integer, we can actually create a double value by just typing something like 3.02, and this is going to be a double value. But of course, we can also do this explicitly again by specifying the type we want to use, and again, assigning some value. And if we scroll down, we see what it has done, and we can print the value again. All right, there's one more to go, and that is storing a single character. Pretty much every programming language has a separate data type to store single characters, and that's called char, or character in some programming languages. So to create a value of type char, we can just do the same thing again, and this is char, which is just a short notation for character, but the data type is called char in Kotlin. And when we define a char, we have to use single quotes like this. And again, I have to scroll down first, and this is gonna, well, this is kind of confusing, but I can create another char, let's call it C2 of type character, and store a, let's say, a Z inside. So this is gonna store this character. Now, the last thing I want to mention is how to basically switch between the types. So all the number types implement functions that let you transform between them. Now, since I've only been using values before, let me just quickly create a float. Let's call it F2 because I've already used F, and assign 3.4F. And this time I'm making it a variable so that I can reassign it. And D3 is a double of 0.0. Let's try to assign the value of F2 to our double. If we try to just say D3 is supposed to be F2, this is going to give us an error because Kotlin again does not want to implicitly transform the float to a double value. But what we can do is we can explicitly call a function on F2 called toDouble. And this is going to allow us to do this assignment. And now if we print D3, this is going to give us the value that was stored in the float before. But note that since the float is not as precise as the double value, this is actually not exactly 3.4. So this is also why floats are not commonly used, because they are very dangerous due to their imprecise storing of the data. Now there are similar functions for all the other types, like toInt or toLong or toShort. And you can play around with them in the REPL and try them out for yourself to get used to transforming between the data types. All right, so now we know all the basic data types we need to know in Kotlin, and I will see you in the next lecture.